279. It's not an imaginary score, but it didn't happen by accident either. In this video, I will explain everything that I have done, the lessons I learned, and the resources I have used. Before we get started, make sure to grab our high-yield resources for Step 1, Step 2, and Step 3. They are packed with everything you need to know about these exams. I will leave the link in the description below. You will sign up and you will start getting them through your inbox. Now let's start with resources. And the first resource I have used is UWorld. Of course, you know that UWorld is the main resource that everyone depends on. And the way I used it was system by system. And this is the way I recommend it for people using it as a learning tool. Now, the way I did it is by trying to learn what the question is actually testing and how this concept can show up on the exam. I didn't try to memorize the stuff early on my prep, but I was always asking myself why this answer is correct and why the other answer is not. So UWorld is about 4,000 questions, and my goal was to finish it in 2 months. Now, to do this, I have to do roughly 2 blocks every day. To stay on track, I was waking up every day at 5 a.m. trying to finish these 2 blocks no matter what. Each block took me about an hour to complete and about 3 to 4 hours to review. Now, of course, as I went deeper in my prep and got a little bit familiar with how these concepts are asked, I started to spend less and less time in the review process. The way I did it was system-wise, timed, and tutor mode. But if I were to do it again, I would recommend going through a timed non-tutor mode to simulate the exam experience, because of course on the exam you wouldn't see the explanation after you answer each question. So by doing this, you are literally mimicking the exam blocks early on in your prep. Now, I actually have done 2 passes of my UWorld. The first one I scored 75%, then on the second one I scored 92%. That said, I think 1 pass of UWorld is more than enough, but while you are doing this, try to really master these concepts. Try to do your UWorld, do your incorrects, and try to make notes or personalize the flashcards out of these incorrects. Now, after mastering your UWorld, if you still need more questions exposure, or if you have done a self-assessment, which we will talk about later, and you still want to increase your score, I recommend doing another question bank better than doing UWorld all over again. And the question bank that I would recommend would be AMBOSS. And here comes the main question, AMBOSS or UWorld? Now, from my experience, the questions on AMBOSS really mimic the exam style. They are very similar to the MBMEs, and even the concept is more similar to what you would see on the exam. On the other hand, I think UWorld is better at the explanations. These tables and the figures that they do will stick into your mind and will help you, especially if you are using it as a learning tool. Now, what makes AMBOSS really stand out is their library and the articles. So they have an amazing articles and the study plan related to each article. Some of AMBOSS articles and the study plan that I actually recommend is the ASICS, biostats, and the quality improvement. You will go through these articles, then you will answer the questions about it. Now, if you finish these articles and you still need more work on the biostats or research, for example, I recommend checking out our biostats and research course. I will leave the link on the description below. Now, I finished AMBOSS in 1 month. I went through 3 blocks every day. And the reason that I did 3 blocks instead of 2 is that, as I told you, the deeper you go through your prep, the easier and the less time consuming your review will take. So I managed to do 3 blocks of AMBOSS instead of the earlier 2 blocks that I was doing from UWorld. Now, my first pass of AMBOSS was about 85%. I did the incorrects and I went through it again, where I scored 92%. Now, I don't recommend going through AMBOSS a second time, as I already memorized all the questions and it felt like I am doing flashcards instead of doing questions. Alongside AMBOSS, I also did the CMS Forms, or the Clinical Mastery Series Forms. Each form has about 50 questions written by the same people that actually do the MBMEs. Now, contrary to what other people say, I didn't find the CMS forms very helpful. They were either very simple or too confusing. Now, the only exceptions was the neurology and OB-GYN, maybe because these were my weak topics, and I actually recommend doing them only on your weak topics and only the recent ones. I have gone through the CMS forms 2 times. The first time I was scoring between 80 to 90%, and the second time I was scoring from 95 to 100%. I actually don't recommend doing all of them. Just do the recent ones and the topics you feel you are weak on. Other resources I would recommend is ChatGPT. You can use it to search an explanation for a question, especially the explanations of the questions on the NBME and the CMS forms. Sometimes they feel insufficient. Another resources I would recommend is our free high yield resources. They are for Step 1, Step 2, and Step 3. They are packed with everything you need to know about the USMLE. We always go through them regularly. Make sure they are updated by the topics we need to know. I will leave the link in the description below. You will sign up and you will start receiving them through your inbox. And for students who want to cover all these high yield materials in a short time, check out our live 7-day USMLE bootcamp. We go over every important topic for Step 1, Step 2, and Step 3 with daily 6 to 8 hours live sessions with the best tutors that explain each of these systems. You will get access to our high yield files, Anki deck, and live and recorded sessions. And it's 100% satisfaction guarantee. If you did the first session with us and you didn't like it, you will get your money back. no questions asked. I would be one of your tutors there. Reserve your seat in the link below. I also went through UWorld Step 3 mainly because I wanted more exposure to questions, as I said earlier. I wouldn't recommend going through all of this though. Maybe just the biostats, quality improvement sections, and the sections you feel you are not confident in. Now here comes the main question. How I prepared for step 1 as an IMG to get this score? Because you know, building a step 1 foundation is one of the most important things to get a high score on step 2. If you can afford it, I highly recommend getting a tutor. They will help you figure out which concepts are important to pass step 1 and also which concepts will carry over through your step 2 CK prep. At the Match Guy, we have over 80 tutors. All of them scored 260 plus. You can try me or any of these amazing tutors for a free one-on-one session. And if you like the style, then you can commit to one of the packages. I will leave the link in the description below. As an IMG, I know how confusing USMLE can feel earlier. It can be extremely different from how medicine is taught in your country. What helped me is picking one system you feel you are comfortable with and starting right away doing your UWorld questions on it. It may feel overwhelming at first, but once you go through it, it will be extremely easy. I have also watched some video content, for example, Boards and Beyonds, Basoma, but I would recommend just going through UWorld, read the explanation very carefully, and if you feel like you didn't understand it, then you can use ChatGPT, for example, or use a tutoring service. After you do your first system and become familiar with how these questions are asked, the rest of the systems will be much easier. For step 1 resources, I kept things simple. I only used UWorld as my learning tool. I have went through all of the anking deck, and this was one of my regrets. It takes too much time from you. So what I would recommend is going through your weak systems on Anki. Do flashcards for your incorrects, for example, and use it for things that require memorization, like pharmacology and microbiology. By the way, I didn't do first aid because I felt like it was over the top after step 1 became bus fail. For my step 1 self-assessments, my NBME scores were between 80 to 90%. I highly recommend going over most of the NBMEs, especially if you have time, because they mimic the exam style and the concept. If you don't have time, just go through the recent ones, and I think if you scored more than 70%, you'd be ready to take your exam. I passed the step 1 in 2023, and building a strong foundation on step 1 made it extremely easier for me to go through step 2. Now let's talk about the self-assessments I have done for step 2 and how did I use them. So my plan was very simple. After finishing each question bank, I will do one NBME. And then I started 4 weeks of dedicated where I went through the rest of the NBMEs and I tried to answer two NBMEs at once, or for example an NBME plus UWorld self-assessment or an NBME plus 3120 to make the exam style. After my first pass of UWorld, I did UWorld self-assessment 1 and I scored 259 on it. Then after finishing AMBOSS, I did the AMBOSS self-assessment and I scored 268 on it, and I think it's extremely underrated. It's predictable, it has a lot of important concepts, so definitely check it out. Then after the CMS Forms and Step 3 UWorld, I have finished NBME 6 to 8, scored 264 on NBME 6, 262 on NBME 7, and 280 on NBME 8. Now I don't think these old NBMEs are predictable, but I recommend going through them for practice. Then I started my 4 weeks dedication. I went through NBME 10 to NBME 15, scored 270 plus on all of them, and I was trying to mimic the exam. On the first week, I did an NBME 10 plus on all the 3120. I scored 275 on NBME 10 and 95% on the 3120. On the second week, I did NBME 11 and another all the 3120. I scored 273 on NBME 11 and 95% again on the other old 3120. On my third week, I did NBME 12 plus UWorld self-assessment 3. I scored 262 on NBME 12 and 264 on my UWorld self-assessment 3, and it was extremely discouraging, and there was a couple of reasons. One of the main reasons is that I didn't have enough sleep, and this should tell you how sleeping is important. I also have done NBME 13 plus NBME 9. I scored 274 on NBME 13 and 270 on NBME 9, which I think was extremely difficult. On the last week of my prep, I did two simulations. The first one was NBME 15 plus UWorld self-assessment 2. I scored 275 on NBME 15 and 277 on the UWorld self-assessment 2. Then I did NBME 14 and the new 3120. I scored 278, just 1 point below my score on NBME 14, and I scored 95% on 3120. NBMEs are not just a score check. I think they are the most valuable resource you could have. Go through the question stem and read it very well. Know how the question is asked and try to figure out your incorrects. I had two main categories of my incorrects that I was making notes for. The first category, is it knowledge gap? Then I would just go through AMBOSS, for example, or do more practice questions on it. The second category, is it a problem with test taking strategy? Then I would try to see the root cause of why I get it wrong and I would try to fix it. Some of the test taking strategies that I would recommend is reading the question from the end, and some of the students misunderstand this. What I mean by reading the question from the end is not just reading what's the next step, for example, but reading the last important information they give you. We prescribed this pharmacology for this patient. What would you recommend? So don't only read what would you recommend, but read the last information, which would usually be the last two sentences of the stem. I would also recommend just skimming through the answer choices, so just you get an idea of what systems they are asking. Oh, yeah. A side note, I think it's extremely important to take care of your mental and the physical health during this dedicated period. I was studying from 12 hours per day, but this didn't prevent me to go to the gym, socialize with my friends at the end of the day. Now, the night before the exam, I slept about 5 to 6 hours, despite training myself to sleep every day at 7 a.m. and waking at 4 a.m., and also despite taking 12 milligrams of melatonin and some ashwagandha thing. When I woke up, I tried not to panic. I went to the store and I grabbed 3 Red Bulls so I can increase my caffeine level if I just crashed out during the exam. I tried not to stress, especially because I have already done some of these NBMEs without sleeping, and I did this on purpose to train myself if anything happens on the exam day. So I arrived at the center 1 hour earlier. I tried to socialize with other test takers just to relieve the stress from myself and from them. Then I went into the exam. I recommend wearing something comfortable, for example, sweatpants, sneakers, so you don't feel stressed, and also bringing a water bottle with you. You can enter the exam room with a water bottle, but make sure to remove the label out of it. So after sitting on your exam, I recommend doing two things. The first thing is to check your audio. Make sure it works well. The second thing is, during watching this tutorial, write down the biostatistics equations so you have them on this paper before entering the exam. And always bring a light jacket with you, because sometimes the air conditioner may feel very cold. Now, I was taking a break after each block. I go to the bathroom, refresh up, take one bite of protein bar. I don't recommend eating sugary or heavy meal, just to avoid the crash out of sugar. During the exam itself, I flagged about 15 questions. The exam felt balanced. Lots of the questions were similar to the style of the NBMEs. The other ones were similar to the style of the UWorld or AMBOSS. So when I saw a question, it felt like I have done it, but I didn't want it to discourage me or make me lose my focus on the exam. I also tried not to search lots of questions during my break, and I didn't take a long break either. It was just a 7-minute break after each block, and I recommend doing this. After the exam, I didn't know what to think about it. I either felt I am scoring 270 plus, or I was just delusional and I missed everything on it. I think this is pretty normal, everyone goes through this. And in my weeks waiting for my results, I actually remember the 260 questions. There was lots of ethics, quality improvement, and weird family medicine vignette. I hope you found this experience helpful. Of course, everyone's experience is a little bit different, but hopefully this helps someone out there looking for guidance. If you need specialized plans just for you, with the best resources you would take and accountability, I highly recommend our tutoring service. You can try a free first session with me or any of our amazing tutors. And if you like the style, then you can commit to one of the packages. Comment below for any questions or reach out to us at info@thematchguide.com. We would appreciate if you like the video and share it out with your friends who is also preparing for their step 2 exam. Don't forget to grab our high yield resources I told you about earlier, and check out Dr. Asad's video on how to prepare for step 2 in 2025. I wish you the best of luck.